Hey, welcome to the eighth people of the night. You know, this is our eighth show, and we don't have any crew. Look at that, the whole studio's empty. We got our cinematographer here. It's Monday night, and got programming on the air still. Gotta go change program, excuse me. Okay, we're back now. Guess we didn't even pause tape there. It's kind of a mess here. Straighten this mess out a little bit. What else we got here? Okay. P-O-T-N number 8. Don't believe any imposter shows. This is the 8th show. Any other shows that claim to be the 8th show, they are not the 8th show. The 8th show is taped all by myself. This is the people of the night. We have some fan mail to Rob, Adam, and Don. They forgot Steve. Steve is a person of the night. It is all creatures big and small. 'Twas he who made them all. And it's a nice little Christmas card here to the people of the night from Timmy Chervenak and Stony Rockin' Seuss. Merry Christmas and good luck on your show. Good luck. We do need good luck on our show. Also got an update here before we get into our show on coffee. Consumers Report has rated coffee in the 1994. Well, it's in the fall, but we never showed it, so it's new for this show. They have rated coffee here. If we go to the table of contents, we'll find out, is coffee bad for you? Something that kind of interesting to me, is coffee bad for you? Okay, coffee and health. Does our bodies pay a price for the boost we get from caffeine? 2.5 centuries after Bach, those who crave coffee still mostly ignore those who urge them to stop drinking the brew. These days, of course, coffee's critics can identify a particular ingredient of concern, that is caffeine, the powerful stimulant that's sometimes described as the world's most powerful drug. A number of foods and drugs, including soft drinks, chocolate, teas, and pain relievers, contain caffeine, an organic compound found in the seeds or leaves of certain plants. But caffeine is consumed primarily in coffee. Coffee contains lots of caffeine. It's right here in the Consumer's Report. Consumer's Report says right here, it says that coffee contains lots of caffeine, relatively speaking, and the drug does have its drawbacks. The mild lift provided by a cup or two of coffee can turn to anxious overstimulation. I think we have a clip on that. Yeah, we have a clip on anxious overstimulation. After the day's fourth or fifth cup, or sooner in those who are particularly sensitive to caffeine. Well, that wouldn't be anyone I know.
There he is. There's Don.
What do you want?
Don, you got to direct our show, man.
Can't.
Why not, Don?
Coffee.
Don, no, Don,
you.
No, Don, our show.
I gotta have coffee.
No.
Get away from me!
Don, we gotta do our show, Don. Don, you have to do our show. No coffee, Don. Don.
Give me some coffee.
No, Don.
I gotta have coffee.
Don, we gotta do our show, Rob. Don, we gotta do our show. Calm down, Don. Coffee is anytime, Don. Our show. We'll be right back with People of the Night.
What are you, an orangutan?
Yeah.
In the meantime, if you should find yourself in Santa Fe,
is that where gloves go?
Yeah.
It might not be a bad idea to leave a single red rose on
the
after all, rumor has it that it was Julia Staub's favorite flower.
Don't
start
acknowledge
him, maybe the Oh, no, he can outlast anybody.
Maybe you should consider switching his battery.
Doug, what are you doing? Are you gonna demonstrate that? Put it on the floor and run it.
I know. Look at the bottom of my rubber.
Okay, we're recording.
Oh, that's
funny.
Help!
You killed it. Oh, God! Oh, jeez! This is it! This sucks! I quit! That's I've had it! Sucks! I quit! I'm done! No more! No more! I'm done!
Oh, yeah, before that.
It'd be through your home video or something. I've never seen this tape before, and there will be doing this.
Yeah, under your bed.
Okay, Chris, knock it
off. Yeah, don't encourage it. Okay, why do you look like a hostage?
No!
Why do you want to be a hostage?
I have nothing to do with this.
I have to go to dinner.
Okay.
I would have been here earlier if I could have found St. John's Street about half an hour ago.
Well, it was at the bank. I said the bank.
I forgot all about the bank thing. What the?
Okay. That's all right.
All I can say is just don't leave the kids
alone with
John.
He's got mittens on his feet.
I don't
yeah.
know.
Yeah, he's got mittens on his feet. Yeah. Very shy. These kids are...
What a bunch.
All right, well, thanks for stopping over.
Yeah, I'll stop over at TCI and...
Yeah, before you go back to school.
Yeah, my friend from New York's coming in, and I want to bring him over.
Okay.
And have him meet all you guys and show him what I do and stuff like that. Nice.
Well, son. Oh, don't write the letter. What is it? There you go.
People who consume caffeine regularly build up a tolerance, usually within days. Some can drink coffee just before bedtime, like myself, and not be kept awake at all. Coffee tolerance, however, is a sign of caffeine dependence. Mm-hmm. This show's kind of going slow because it is taped so late at night. Oh, look at this. This is the chemical, to zoom in on this, this is the chemical makeup of caffeine. All right, we're going to have a little chemistry lesson here. Let's get this set up here. There we go. Too bad I don't have a crew for the eighth show. It's kind of slow, I know. Hello. There we go. All right. Get this right over here. Get that chemical makeup of caffeine here. We still got sound there, Hal? Okay. Yeah, we are. Okay. Okay, we got, three atoms of hydrogen, one of carbon joined to a nitrogen. Got a oxygen. Oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, hydrogen. Well, these are the basic building blocks of life. How can that be bad for you? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Basic building blocks of life. Okay. Kind of confused on this caffeine thing. Okay. We got kind of an interesting show for you. We're going to probably edit out lots of parts of this. Keep it moving.
Back together, it's fun, man. This is great.
But I've never been allowed to do a top 10 list. Never really had much headroom on this show either. I better go tilt the camera up. Wish I had a crew. Like, show that there's no crew here. Look at that. There's just nobody here. It's just ridiculous. Trying to schedule a show. There's no guests. There's no crew. There's no camera people. There's no producer. It's kind of ridiculous. Anyway, what we have here is our top 10 list, and it was written by somebody named Madonna Veronica Ciccone. Isn't that interesting? Oh, she's known as Madonna, too. quoted in Esquire magazine, top 10 lists, prepared but never read on The Late Show with David Letterman. The Late Show, that's kind of like a show we have, late show, late night, Jason Naylor. Madonna Ciccone's top 10 complaints about David Letterman. And this is what she didn't have the nerve to read. It's very funny. It's quoted in Esquire magazine. Top 10 complaints about Dave. Couldn't Vogue if life depended on it. Have to agree with her on that. Always asking, whatever happened to that nice Sean Penn? I could believe that. You know what? I'm forgetting to read the numbers. Let me start that over. Top 10 lists, my top 10 complaints about Dave from Madonna. Number 10, couldn't Vogue if life depended on it. That's kind of believable. Couldn't say a top 10 list if his life depended on it. Number 9.5, Don Bilinski couldn't say a top 10 list if his life depended on it. Number 9, always asking, whatever happened to that nice Sean Penn? Always asking the audience. Okay. stole his nickname, Material Girl, from me. Kind of a slam there, and good old Dave. Remember Dave Letterman, good old Dave. I think he's on right now, in fact. Maybe he's already off because this Fox, CBS, yeah, I think we got something else there on CBS. That's rather interesting. Number 7. Before sex, always ask, do you have any music for this, Paul? That's kind of funny. Do you have any music for this, Paul? Paul Schaefer. Before sex, always ask, do you have any music for this, Paul? That is funny. I don't really do that. It's a caricature that somebody made up. Number six, I cannot read. Number 5, driving isn't the only thing he does too fast, if you know what I mean. It's from Madonna about Dave Letterman. Driving isn't the only thing he does too fast, if you know what I mean. Number 4, his top 10 lists keep getting lamer and lamer. Hit the nail right on the head. Number 3, calls cops every time I break into his house. That's what Madonna says about David Letterman. Number 3, calls the cops every time I break into his house. Number 2, doesn't look good in a cone bra. Well, not as good as Madonna. The number one complaint about David Letterman from Madonna, he's still a virgin. Yep, that's our top 10 list for show number 8. And we couldn't even read reason number 6. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We are on the 8th show, and what we have here is a cup of coffee. Consumer Reports coffee. I know you guys are getting sick of this. You guys are getting sick of the coffee jokes. Getting sick of the top 10 lists. Getting sick of the talent on the show, or lack of. But you know what? We don't really care. We don't care. Anybody understand that?
Use macro for that.
Is it running?
Yeah.
When Bitrue?
Juncture.
Rockley at this juncture.
I don't know if he's 67. Continue.
Maybe it's already like 85 over there. Oh, this is exciting. We got like less than a minute. We got seconds. Isn't that weird? We got seconds left in 1994.
Do you have any last sauce?
I don't have any last sauce for this year. It's okay. Weird. It's
so weird.
Grants. It's already 1995. Some part of the world.
Look at that. 10 seconds. 10 seconds left in 1994. I do it out here. Wow. Wait.
Put him, stand. Stand, put him. They're screaming.
Isn't it weird?
See, Doug.
Look
at here. Who are you? Who are you, Doug? What are you?
Mama.
Did you see him going wrong?
For the longest time, we couldn't get him to say his real name.
What did he say his name was?
Mama.
He used to make up names for himself.
Incognito. You would ask him, what is your name? He goes, Mama.
Not add it, make it go by it. That's too fast. Oh, man. What we have here at 12:45 in the morning
on pass,
channel 20. We have a volleyball game going on.
Too much on it. It's dead, I'm serving. July 4.
You know, I don't think they're as good as that Don Bilinski guy in TCI Sports. I don't know. Maybe they are.
Shaven? You got whiskers? Who came over yesterday?
Robert.
Robert, what did he get? Did he get a scarf? Did he get a scarf? Do you like it? Good thing that's not a blade. You washing your tongue? Is it dirty?
Welcome back, folks. This is People of the Night 1995. Yes, I graduated this year. Okay, well, it's time for that time of show, you know, viewer fan mail. Well, anyways, here's Willie. You know, everybody knows Willie. My pride and joy. Because I don't have a kid or a girlfriend, so he's pride and joy. He goes there with me. We go to the, oh, anyways. Okay, our first letter is from Riverview, Michigan, zip 48192. We'll say this one for a minute. And, wait a minute, I'm wrong. I lied, that's our second letter. Our first one is from Trenton, Michigan, zip 48183. Okay, letter reads, our Rob J. Pratt, care of People of the Night, TCI Cablevision, la la la, address not important right now. We'll give you that in a little bit. We have a new address, if you know what I mean. Okay. If you will, I'm not good at reading aloud, so you all hang with me, okay? December the 5th, 1994, last year. Dear R.J. Pratt, that's Rob, he's not here. It reads, if you will, my daughter and I have seen the most recent People of the Night show three times running and wonder if you, yes, you, Rob, you wonder if you have or ever have worked at Ray's Prime Beef in Trenton. You know, you can pay your bills there for TCI Cable, I think. Okay. There is an employee there that looks a lot like you. We are unable to make a positive ID. Meaning, for all you like little 7-year-olds, they don't know if it's him or not. Okay? Simple as that. Just wondering if that was you, Rob. Well, Mrs. Barb Grooms, if that is your real name, which we hope so. No, it's not Rob. He don't work there. Rob used to work at the LPCC, which stands for Lincoln Park Community Center, but that job was too hectic for one day, so ting, we got the quitter on that one. Okay, we have a PS here. We love PSs. We enjoy the nine inch nails lip sync too. That's excellent. We also enjoy the 9 inch nails lip sync too. We thought it was great. We did it at 1:30 in the morning. We're really talented. We're crazy. Oh, we have a little side note here. My 18-year-old daughter wonders if you have a girlfriend, and she thinks you're really hot. Rob. This is from Barb Grooms. I think that's Barb Grooms in Trenton. Barb, There's your Trent letter. It's an official People of the Night letter. See, folks, it's official. Woo! Psychedelic. Okay, so you can't lie. We're not like other shows, you know. I say, hey, we got those letters. Well, we got them, baby. We got the real thing. Okay. Okay, that's great. We got it. One letter here. This was in the beginning of December, like the 5th, I think. We got it, we got like the 11th, because it usually takes a day for us, our mail thing. Anyways, so this is good. Okay, this one came quite a surprise to me because I thought this is a little unreal. But yes, we did get another letter from viewer. My microphone is right here. I just can't, I don't want to be in the way. Okay, this is from Riverview, Michigan. People of the Night, TCI Cablevision. This is the Lincoln Park Studio. We have a new address. 1954 Liberty, folks. Care of Potten, P-O-T-N. All letters will be received and read on the air along with you. Thank you very much. And if you do not see this, we are going to write back. You know what, folks? Here's what I want you guys to do. All right, now I think about this. We're going to be here. Today is the 16th of January. I believe this is showing tonight, the A show. So if you're out there watching, we'll be here tonight when the show airs. So I want you to call me. I'll be here, honey. I'll be here. I want you to call me. Say ring, ring, ring. Say give me a call. Say, we'll tell you what's up. What's up? I'm being slurish here. This is a long one. We'll tell you what's up. We'll get some phone messages. You know, we'll do the phone thing. You know what I'm saying? And we'll be hip happening, happening. All right. This is 1995. The year Adam graduates. Okay. This is the 21st of December, written in 1994, last year, once again. All right. Dear people of the night, that would be us. Although we hate to admit that we watch Public Access, losing my mic, don't we all? We all hate to admit it. Although we hate to admit we watch Public Access, my friend and I do watch your show, our show, not any other show, our show. We think it's an offbeat and can relate to your ethnic scenes of humor. Sense. Ethnic sense of humor. Anyway, we saw a rerun of your first show. And there was some kind of contest for the first 100 responses. We are almost positive. This is what embarrasses us, I think. But I don't know. We are almost positive that my letter falls. This letter here. That my letter. Where am I at? Falls within the range, so we expect Rob to pour us a cup of coffee, and we accept no substitutions. We prefer to get the prize before January 9th, because once college starts up again, our schedule come hectic. You know, mine too. I know that's college scene. You know, I'm still in high school. But if that's possible, we can make arrangements. You know, guys, I'm 19. We can make. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just going crazy. I just had a birthday. Thanks. we can, college starts up on the, up again on the 9th, which was like 2 weeks ago, and if we can't have you on the show, hold on here, folks, I'm going crazy. Here we go. We prefer to get the prize before January 9th, because once college starts up again, our schedule will become hectic, but if that's impossible, we can make arrangements. So, also, we are sick of you. This is what really got me and Rob. I were wondering. We are sick of you guys complaining that you can't get girlfriends. Well, I'm kind of sick of it, too. Well, I would date Rob in a second, and my friend, really, and we have it underlined like 6 or 7 times, really, 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 really wants Adam. Well, Irene, I would really like to meet you because I really, 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 I don't know. We're just waiting for the opportunity. We're sick of being treated like dirt, too. Well, Allison, join the club. I'm treated like garbage, okay? I have the most cakes. I don't know where that came from. Anyways, cakes. It's cakes. Okay, this is from Allison Lytle, L-I-D-D-L-E, out of Trenton, and my friend Irene. I think she's our friend now. I can hear my eyes. So, Allison and Irene, love ya. We want to meet you. We want you to call us tonight and call us. And if at all possible, you can't call us here at the studio at 675-2001. You can give me a call at 323-3890, and that's my pager number. And you could page me and put dash number one or number two, because, hey, you're the best, big girls. You know what I'm saying? Okay, 323-3890. Our address for people tonight is care of 1954 Liberty, Lincoln Park, Michigan, zip 48146. Back to you, Don.
Slow down.